Welcome back to Oslo Grand Prix. Some great athletics already this evening. Linford Christie winning a fantastic 100 metres. Moses Kiptanui already going very close to what would have been the evening's first world record. They tend to expect world records here. Unlikely that they'll get one in this race though. The women's 400 hurdles. Obviously without Sally Gunnell, who's trying to come back to some competitive form in Sheffield this weekend, but not over the hurdle. She's still having problems with her Achilles and her heel. So she won't be running in Gothenburg in this event. She's hoping to possibly make the relay team, which leaves the door open for some of these athletes. Tonya Buford there from the USA will be one of the favorites going into Gothenburg. Kim Batten also from the USA. We saw Dion Hemmings in lane two before that. Nana Knoros from Russia. But this young lady could well be the favorite now. Marie-José Perec from France. So running very well in Nice a few nights ago. And the flat 450.2. And Ordina from Russia will be in the outside lane in lane six. Probably not a good draw for Perec. She's got Buford, Batten, and indeed Hemmings inside her. Hemmings has been in great form in terms of winning on the Grand Prix circuit. Rome, Seville, Saint-Denis, and Gateshead. Where they go first time, then, as I said, Perec out in lane five has got the two Americans and Jamaican inside her, but she's gone up very, very hard indeed. Has already passed Ordina from Russia outside her. So it's Perec already leading them out down the back straight. Tonya Buford in lane three is probably making up some ground on Kim Batten. It's Perec who's making the pace there. Dion Hemmings beginning to move up in lane two inside Tonya Buford. But Perec really has stolen the march on them over the first 200 metres. And she's going to come into the home straight with probably a 4 or 5 meter advantage. Perec it is, with that graceful action of hers, taking the hurdles in a stride. As I said, 4 or 5 meters up now. Dion Hemmings coming through in lane two, but it's Perec out in front. Perec, it looks to have this one won. Hemmings is in second place, trying to hang on. Kim Batten coming through now, but Maria Perec, 53.93. Very, very fast indeed. Her previous personal best, that smashes it. 54.48 was her best before this, 53.93. That's a new national record. It's also the second fastest time in the world this year, only beaten by Tonya Buford, and that was very, very impressive. If you bear in mind, she was out there in lane five, couldn't see the athletes inside her. She went out very, very hard, and really, Tim, in the first 200 metres, she just about had the race won.
Yes, by far the best we've seen of Perec so far this year of 400 metre hurdles. Not just because she's run the fastest time she's ever done, the new French record, but because her hurdling tonight, for the first time, looked reasonably competent to me. She's looked pretty awful in several of her previous races. She's admitted herself to the media. But on several occasions, down that back straight and round that final bend, she looked very, very solid over the barriers. She looked more comfortable with the hurdles tonight, and that's important. And I really do feel that that run will have done a great deal for her confidence. Another interesting thing too is that when she came under a little pressure from Hemmings in lane two down the home straight, she was able to lengthen her stride and open up again and open up the gap in the last 30 or 40 metres. And that's a very, very important and rare quality when the acid is climbing onto your back and your legs are getting very, very heavy. Then you're able to open up your legs and maintain that stride length when everybody else is faltering. And she won there very convincingly indeed, Marie-José Perec. And I think that one puts her out there as strong favourite for the World Championship. She's beaten all the other top women in the world this year in that race. Sally Gunnell, as Steve said, not going to be in Gothenburg. But Perec is certainly, if the programme allowed it, I think she could probably win both the 400 and 400 hurdles in Gothenburg.